to St. Michael's online worship on this third Sunday after Pentecost. Please follow the service from the order of service that you've received or that is online. Gladden the souls of your servants, O God.
To you, O Lord, we lift up our hearts.
The Lord is good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love.
Listen to our cries, O God, and answer.
God is great and does wondrous things.
So we come to worship and bow down before you, O Lord.
So let us glorify the Lord together. God of grace, you created our minds to grow in wisdom.
You created our hearts to expand with love for you and your word.
You created our voices to sing your praises forever. Fill us to overflowing with your Holy Spirit, so we may worship you in spirit and in truth. Bold and unafraid to follow you. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God, you servants of the Lord.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's name, now and forever.
Let us pray together the glory. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. We pray together the Collect. Let us pray. Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid,
cleanse the thoughts of our hearts, by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Go see, see how gele. Go see, see how gele. Go see, go see. See how gede Christe, see how gede Christe, see how gede Christe, Christe, see how gede go see, see how gede. See how gede go see, go see, see how gede.
Let us ask pardon from the Lord for all the times when our shortcomings kept us from letting the light of Christ shine. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone, for the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you, pardon your sins, and set you free from them, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray together the collect for today. Lord Jesus Christ, you tell us not to be afraid, challenge us to abandon ourselves, encourage us to risk the sacrifice, and that we may find the abundant life you promise. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit in the unity of the Blessed Trinity, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
For the purposes of this recording, we will be reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew. But concerning the other readings, please find this in the order of service.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Hear my prayer, O Lord, listen to my cry for mercy. When I am in distress, I call you because you will answer.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The reading is taken from Matthew chapter 10, verse 24 to 39. The student is not above the teacher, nor a servant above his master. It's enough for students to be like their teachers, and servants like their masters. If the head of the house has been called Beelzebul, how much more the members of his household? So do not be afraid of them, for there is nothing concealed that will not be disclosed, or hidden that will not be made known. What I tell you in the dark, speak in the daylight. What's whispered in your ear, proclaim from the roofs. Do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather be afraid of those who destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them fall to the ground outside your Father's care. And even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. So don't be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Whoever acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge them before my Father in heaven. But whoever disowns me before others, I will disown before my Father in heaven. Do not suppose that I will come to bring peace to earth. I did not come to bring peace, but a sword, for I have come to turn a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemies will be the members of his household. Anyone who loves their father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Anyone who loves their son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Whoever does not take up their cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds their life will lose it. Whoever loses their life for me, for my sake, will find it.
Greetings to you, the online community of St. Michael's and those beyond. In our scriptures this Sunday, we encounter God, a God who is faithful, a God who invites us to look beyond our own resources and self-interest, being able to embrace the larger vision of life. That when trouble surrounds us, we are not alone. and we encounter a God who reassures us and reminds us that God is with us. In the first reading, in Genesis, Hagar is distraught after her banishment together with her son, and she cries out to God in anguish, and we see God responding and providing means for both their survival. What this teaches us is that our cries for help are part of a myriad of other voices and influences within which God is at work. In the second reading, in his letter to the Romans, the Apostle Paul recognizes the destructive power of sin, but he counterbalances that with the saving power of Christ. He further talks about the Christian journey being a process of dying to self. We die to the past, to sin, and to old ways of being. Then we rise to new possibilities and an open future in God. In Christian spirituality, dying to self often points to letting go of our individualistic selves in order to open ourselves up to a much wider vision of life. So in today's gospel passage, which is the end of Jesus' commissioning speech to his disciples, he preaches and instructs the 12 for the continuation of his mission. He instructs them that they are to demonstrate what God's kingdom looks like, to bring new possibilities for healing, to bring new possibilities for wholeness, for telling the truth, and to repair relationships. Earlier in the same chapter, Jesus empowered his disciples to do the things that he does, to cast out demons, heal people with every kind of sickness, teach about God's ways. We too struggle to fully understand Jesus' power and to keep the faith. That is why Jesus encourages his disciples not to fear those who might contradict or even persecute them. So in this gospel passage, Matthew reminds his listeners and subsequently reminds us as we read today to embark on the path of Christ, embracing both the joys and the tragedies of life in their totality. Here too, we become aware that part of embracing these seemingly contradictory realities of life is to let go of self-interest and embrace a larger vision of life, which is the vision of God for us. Dying to self and losing your life takes us beyond the anxieties of the present moment to finding meaning in God. No longer are we imprisoned by the past, we now journey forth with new life. And this is not just a pie in the sky kind of teaching. The mystic theologian Meister Eckhart expressed it in these words. He said, "Even now, one rarely hears of people achieving great things unless they first stumble in some respect." And then he goes on to say, "For the person who has learned to let go and let be, nothing can ever get in their way again." This is the message that Jesus wanted to give to his disciples. You can imagine him standing in front of his disciples, probably naive disciples. When he pauses, then he equips them with his final spiritual gift, the ability to persevere in the face of resistance. Then he reminds them that our Heavenly Father is both incredibly powerful and infinitely compassionate. He assures them, one, that on this journey of faith, as they go out, they will encounter opposition. And so he starts with that wise kind of saying that they will be called names. And as we know, names do hurt us when we are called names. And he reminds them of that. He said they will be even misunderstood. And by so doing, he's telling them that their lives will not be easier than his. And then he urges them to embrace the life of faith with all of its pains and glory. Secondly, he says on this journey, they will encounter God's love. He urges them to have no fear of those who might abuse them. In this gospel passage, he is so insistent that he repeats three times that they need not be afraid. He encourages them to speak boldly, to remember that they are answerable to no one except God, who alone has the power over both their bodies and their souls. And so Jesus says in the Gospel, "Do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, fear him who can destroy both soul and body." Now we know our society is saturated with anxiety, with worry, and with fear. For many of us, fear has become a lifestyle that demands some kind of relief, some kind of therapy. What do we fear? What fills our heads with dread? What keeps us awake at night in these uncertain and disturbing times? Well, the list is long. Financial uncertainty, continued isolation, especially our elderly folk who are vulnerable. We also fear impoverishment and loss of our homes. We fear violence, and ultimately we fear death itself. But some of us are simply afraid of facing our own deepest fear, so we spend most of our time hiding away from ourselves. So how do these words of Jesus, "Do not fear," breathe new life in the hearts of us who are fearful and powerless and voiceless? We have good news to share with our neighbors, with our friends, co-workers, and others. Many people out there are waiting for this good news. In his memoir, Secrets in the Dark, Frederick Biertner has these encouraging words to say. He says, "We have it in us to work miracles of love and healing, as well as to have them worked upon us. We have it in us to bless with God and forgive with God and heal with God, and once in a while, maybe even to grieve with some measure of God's grief at another person's pain." That is the good news. That no matter how fragile our faith and how fierce our fear may be, we have freedom in Christ. We walk with God. We encounter our Lord Jesus in the Word and in the Sacrament and in a community that is gathered as you do now at home. We walk by faith through the gift of the Holy Spirit. God is faithful and invites us to look beyond our own resources and self-interest to a larger vision of life, so that when trouble surrounds us, we are not alone, and that we are reminded at all times that God is with us. Glory to Him whose power, resting in us, can do infinitely more than we can ever ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with His love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us pray.
Heavenly Father, thank you for waking us up to this new day you blessed us with, and for providing us with our basic necessities, which we sometimes take for granted. Dear Lord, the challenges and impact of coronavirus on our jobs, health and loss of lives, the racial discrimination, the senseless killing of women and children, the abuse in homes are too heavy for us. Protect us against these adversities. We pray for the people around the world to be steadfast in prayers, to grow in faith and pray with hope. We pray for the Anglican Communion in Nigeria, the Most Reverend Henry Chukwudum Duguba, Metropolitan and Primate of all Nigeria, and Bishop of Abuja. Unite us in prayer. Bless all people and children across the churches in the universe. Thank you for your blessings.
Father God, in a world full of conflict, confusion, and uncertainty, we need leaders who can guide us. Please inspire our clergy, faith leaders, and our youth at St. Michael's Church with wisdom, love, and grace, that as they pray for us and pray with us, counsel and comfort us, they do so guided by the Holy Spirit. Bless their families as well, Lord. We ask this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen.
God, you alone are worthy of honor, glory, and praise. Give our leaders wisdom, discernment, and strength. Keep them healthy, safe, and rested, so that they can guide us through these difficult times. Give our government leaders wisdom on how to stop the coronavirus and stabilize our economy. Give our spiritual leaders your discernment on how to meet people's needs as they glorify your name and encourage the church. Father God, give our medical leaders insight into how to stop the virus, strengthen their resources, Father God, and honor their hard work in creating a treatment for the coronavirus. And help us, as the leaders in our communities, to display courage, hope, and generosity, and kindness. In Jesus' name, amen.
Heavenly Father, hear us as we pray for the needs of our nation, particularly during this COVID-19 period. Your people are broken through fear, uncertainty, loss of hope and despair, stigmatization, gender-based violence, and loss of employment and income. We ask that you make our shattered lives whole again, that you look upon your people with your merciful compassion, and that you transform our lives for your glory.
Heavenly Father God, we thank you for being with us. We do not take it for granted that we are alive, Lord. It is through your love and mercies. As we venture into the new world, bless us all throughout the world, Lord. As you said in your word in Psalm 121, be with us in your wonderful name. Amen.
Merciful Father, we bring before you the sick. Touch them with your healing hands. We also pray for those who are dying. Remind them of your faithfulness to your promises. Shine your eternal light into their hearts and give them peaceful rest by your side. For the bereaved, comfort and strengthen them. Lessen the burden of pain and grief in their broken hearts, that they may feel the hope and promises of a better and brighter tomorrow.
Shall we pray for God's mercy to sustain us in the coming 22nd week? Lord, we are currently living in fear of COVID-19 and its effects. Protect us from this disease, guide our steps and hide us from it. To those already infected, pour your grace and merciful healing. Give us wisdom and discretion as we navigate through this difficult road together. Be our rock, our defense and our salvation so that we will not be moved or shaken by these happenings. Preserve our going out and our coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen.
Merciful God, accept these our prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray together a blessing over the offerings, the gifts and the donations that you made so generously towards St. Michael's Church. God of love and provision, in deep gratitude for life and for all the blessings that come from you, we offer back to you some measure of what you have been given. Accept our offerings and use them. Use us for the building up of your kingdom in this world. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Done on earth.
Thanks to God for all God's gifts to us. Father, we give you thanks and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, for birth and life and strength of body, for safety and shelter and food. We give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
For sight and hearing, the beauty of nature, for words and music, the power of thought, we give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
For work and leisure and the joy of achieving, for conscience and will and depth of feeling, we give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
For grace and truth in Jesus Christ, for the gift of the Spirit and the hope of heaven, we give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
Eternal God, our beginning and our end, accompany us in this day's journey. Dawn on our darkness, open our eyes to praise you for your creation and to see the work you set before us today. Take us and use us to bring to others the new life you give us in Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.